Let's talk about two players over from the Laval Rocket and how their paths have been laid out and how those paths could have been seen as a little bit of a variation, a deviation, a change from what was in store, let's say at this point a year or two ago. So, we're talking today first off about Ryan Poehling, a Montreal Canadiens first-round talent, back from the 2017 NHL Entry Draft, a guy who had a lot more star power in the past than what he has now, and we're also talking about Cayden Primeau, the guy who many people believe is the best Montreal Canadiens goaltending prospect, and, ironically enough, has the same initials as Carey Price. Cue all of the next in line for the CP starting that minor in Montreal jokes with this Cayden Primeau over here. But we're talking about these two today because we've seen a few interviews and a few overall pieces of news that go over just exactly what the plans are for these guys. Let's go over Ryan Poehling first and foremost, because Ryan Poehling is a guy who has indeed had a lot more star power before compared to where he is at right now. He's a guy who, back when he was a 2017 draft pick, was taken 25th overall by the Habs. Afterwards, though, he kind of put himself on the map in a big way, because in 2017-2018, he was just under a point per game as a member of the St. Cloud State University Hockey Club in the NCAA. He produced at the exact same rate the next season, putting himself in the conversation to being one of the more valuable players in the entire college division. He made the NCHC first All-Star team that year and had an extended role for Team USA at the World Juniors, where in 7 games played, he had 5 goals and 3 assists for 8 total points. This was what put him on the map as what many people considered a very legit NHL prospect. He made the All-Star team at the World Juniors, he was dubbed the best forward, the MVP, a top 3 player on his team, and he won the silver medal with Team USA. So, for Ryan Poehling as a guy who was taken at the end of the 2017 first round, people at this point in time were saying, okay, this guy potentially could be a middle six, top six kind of center if he develops properly. A nice two-way player with good defensive instincts, strong work ethic, and an overall projectable game with some nice defensive skills. But that hype was brought to the moon and back, because when he suited up for the Montreal Canadiens shortly after signing his contract, he scored 3 goals against the Toronto Maple Leafs in his debut. He also was put out there in the shootout, and he scored there too. In fact, it was the shootout-winning goal as the Canadiens defeated Toronto in the Bell Center. So you could kind of see why, immediately after that, everybody's expectations, not just in Montreal, but around the league, were kind of getting out of hand. Everybody was saying, okay, this Ryan Poehling guy just did exactly what Austin Matthews did, and I get that that was a meme, but at the same time, there were many people that were saying, okay, this guy just got a hat trick in his first game, he has got so much more to prove, who knows how many goals we see out of him in his first full pro season with the Canadiens, hopefully he gets up to the 263 mark easily. But long story short, that did not happen, because Ryan Poehling was okay in the preseason. I remember watching some of these games, we covered them on the channel, especially the one where him and Alex Belzile kind of went to town on the Florida Panthers. But long story short, let's just sum it up in one word: injuries. He ended up splitting some time with both the Canadiens and the Laval Rocket. In Laval, he had 13 points in 36 games. With the Canadiens, though, he only had 2 points in 27 games. He had an entire 1-game span in 2018-19 where he bested out his entire season's worth of Habs performance on the score sheet in 2019-20. Furthermore, this is cemented by the fact that he didn't actually play in the postseason. He was sidelined with an injury before the season stopped up, but he was indeed brought back and he was indeed a part of the Canadiens' overall camp and their return to play roster. He just didn't play. So now, we have this article that came over here on La Presse talking about what exactly we hope for Ryan Poehling to happen in the future. The article goes over the entire story of Ryan Poehling as we have talked about it here, and then we have the quotes, because this is what Ryan Poehling said himself about not playing in the postseason for 2020. I don't know if I deserved at least a game or not, but I was frustrated. This moment will help me grow. I'm taking the offseason more seriously than in the past, and that's a good thing. I want to be ready for camp and let them know they can count on me in the future. I want them to regain confidence in me. Furthermore, here in the article, we have ourselves an analysis of Ryan Poehling's entire strategy in the return-to-play format, where he kind of took things lightly and subtly admitted it to Grant McKay, who was interviewing him. When the pandemic started, I wasn't sure what was going to happen. We were in lockdown, so I chose to move to Florida for 2 months. The temperature was pleasant, while it was still cold in Minnesota, where he's from. When I finally realized that hockey was going to pick up, I returned to Minnie and trained for 6 weeks before joining the team. Eventually, he didn't play. And now we have ourselves a different discussion to have, because when it comes to Ryan Poehling and his overall projection into the NHL, a lot of people would say he kind of needs to make the NHL next year. But the fact is, he's going to have to battle out with Suzuki, Kotkaniemi, and Philippe Deneau on top of him on the depth chart. So the question is, do you want to see Ryan Poehling develop at 21 years old as a fourth line center playing his first full NHL season? Many would say no, which is why he actually says over here, it would be amazing to play on a line with Nick Suzuki and or Jesperi Kotkaniemi. They're both amazing players and great guys. I can't predict the future, but if I was asked to play kite surfing, I will. Playing on the left wing won't hurt me. The article then goes over it. The center position, it's clogged. Right wing, it's clogged. But on the left wing, you have Drouin and Tatar, who might not be here for more than a year. Paul Byron is there too, but if you want to start, maybe it is a Ryan Poehling you put over there on the left side. You give him that opportunity to play in the top nine, and you see where you go from there. Whether or not that's going to happen or not, who knows? But the idea is brought up here, and Poehling himself says if the Habs play him on the wing, hey, he's got no problem with it. So when it comes to the Ryan Poehling projection for 2020-2021, there certainly is a very interesting conversation to have there. We know the Canadiens just got rid of Max Domi, but they added a whole bunch of other forward depth. Anderson, different dynamic than Domi, a very nice player to add. You also have Tyler Toffoli, who is coming over here and being a different scoring presence as well. Not to mention the fact that you still have the pretty good centers that you have. Say what you want about Kotkaniemi, the guy still has 0 points in the Liga, but he's only played 4 games. But for Ryan Poehling, we'll see how things go. And my goodness, we spent so much time on Poehling, we have such little time to discuss Cayden Primeau, the guy whom we're also talking about here in this video. Cayden Primeau, everybody kind of knows the story of Primeau. He was drafted out of the 7th round in that same 2017 draft. He became amazing for the Northeastern University Huskies, was one of the best goaltenders in the entire NCAA as a freshman, and then as a sophomore. He signed over with the Canadiens. He played a few games this season, actually, and he was okay. A 9.31 save percentage in 2 Habs games. Not bad in the slightest, but his biggest body of work came with the Laval Rocket, 33 games played, a 2.45 goals against average, and a 9.08 save percentage. Well, we had ourselves a quote over here that came out over onto the media. This is from Stefan White, who says that the plan is for Cayden Primeau to get at least 150 AHL games of experience under his belt before eventually making the jump to the NHL. So, assuming the AHL season kind of gets paused up and it doesn't go on for the full 70-something games, and let's say Cayden Primeau starts about, I don't know, 50% of maybe 50 or 60 games that the AHL will have next season. We're going to have ourselves quite a few years of Cayden Primeau developing with Laval before he reaches that 150-game mark. He's at 33 right now, so do the math, he has about 120 more games to go. If he plays every game for the AHL season, and assuming the AHL goes on for its full length of time, at minimum, we're seeing Cayden Primeau suited for the Canadiens in 2021-2022. Now, with the whole Jake Allen extension and the fact that you still have Carey Price, whose contract goes on forever, who knows how exactly that transition is going to be, but at the end of the day, the fact that the Canadiens did sign Jake Allen, and they still have that OGCP in Carey Price, it means that you are not rushing Cayden Primeau in the slightest. You are giving this guy all the opportunities to be the best version of himself before coming up to Montreal. He played in relief with Montreal earlier in the season and he was okay. He was actually great, but he's only 21 years old. Come on, give this guy an opportunity to really establish himself, take over the AHL first and foremost, and then we'll see what he does once Allen is eventually taken off of the team. Either his contract extension that he signed expires, which is going to be a few years from now, or we see him get taken by Seattle. Who really knows? But at the end of the day, this has been our update on 2 Canadiens prospects, Ryan Poehling and Cayden Primeau, 2 guys that I have been very hyped for in the past. Talk to me in the comments what you think I would be enjoyed. This was Richard Ashworth, 99. And bye.